This conference will now be recorded.
So last yesterday, right? Last class, right? So in the last class, what we discussed, what is a list? So what is a list, guys? List is nothing but a collection of record. So every customer there, we can search the record, sort the record, and we can be able to edit and modify the records from list view, right? So now I can open that my list view, any table list view. In this case, I can navigate to incident table. So navigate incident table, just click on that all module, right? So in this particular application or list view, incident list view, we have so many fields, like records are available. List nothing but a collection of records. Every customer, they can be able to search the particular record, sort the record, nothing but apply the filter condition. Already we've seen that how many ways we can apply the filter condition. And we can edit and modify the record as well. All right. So now I'm going to show how to apply the filter condition in multiple ways. Right. So priority, you cannot give in one. So when you click on that enter, this is a list view one search condition. All right. So what about this one? Already we discussed, right? So when you apply the filter condition, automatically form the breadcrumb. So in the breadcrumb behind the sum, query is going to executing the service node table. So where the condition meet, display the particular records to the table. So if you want to remove any particular condition, right? Suppose how to apply the filter condition in advanced level. Same like that, go to my count symbol. This is called advanced level filter condition. All right. So based on your requirement or client requirement, they can apply the multiple condition, right? Active is true. And priority is equivalent to one, and the category should be right software. So when you click on that run, so display the records which are meet my condition. Okay, so this is nothing but a breadcrumb. If you want to remove any particular condition from here, just click on that here. Automatically, one horizontal bar will be highlighting. So automatically remove it. Display the remaining condition where the condition meet. And if you want to remove entire condition from that condition builder, all. Okay. And go to that, how to apply the filter condition through condition builder. That is called advanced level filter condition. See, field name, so many SQL operators already we've seen is equivalent, is one of, is not equal to, is not empty, between, so many operator, right? All SQL operators given by company by default, based on their client requirement, they can apply the condition. Using by the different operators already we seen. And the next one is already quick search. Third one, right? How to apply the condition through search boxes. When you click on that search boxes, automatically display all the search boxes under the each column. So now again, I'm going to give in that one, priority one, and the same like that, the state is closed. I want to display the only closed records. And then same time, I need to get it only network, right? See, my condition meet only one record. Where my priority one, state enclosed, category, that should be network. Where my condition meet, display the records to the customer, right? So mainly why we're going to work in that like a list view. So in that list view, we have different, like so many records are available. That every table may be contain so many records. So from that lot of records, right? What happened here, guys? See, very important thing is go to that all. See, now we have 82 records in my basic instance. If you talk about the real-time organization, every table may contain lack of records. From lack of records, how can you get open particular record from the table, right? It's very difficult to searching the manually. That's why they're given by default, we can be able to apply the filter condition, sort the record, search the record, right? From out of 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs records, You can be able to look at any single record, multiple records where the condition meet. Okay, and next search is, so next search is quick search. So right click on that quick search. First of all, go to that all, remove the all the condition from the table, and all that records are display in my list view. This is called list view, right? So sorry. So now I'm going to work in the quick search. Right click on that any particular value, show matching, display the only priority one tickets. Again, I'm going to click on that, right click on that in progress, show matching, right? Where the my condition meet in progress. Same like that, right click on the software, show matching, right? So my condition meet the record, that is called quick search. Any customer they want get the records quickly, when apply the different filter condition from the table, then automatically display to the customer. Priority equal to one and state equal to in progress, category should be software. So my condition meet only three record, that is called quick search. Next one is right click on this one and filter out. So filter out is equivalent to, it's the opposite of the show matching, right? So excluding the value, suppose filter out, it will be excluding that priority one tickets, that would be critical, and displaying the high, moderate and low planning, right? In case if you want to exclude the filter out also in progress, that in progress record not going to display, and close as well, show matching, close the record as well, right? And right click on that inquiry, sorry, yes, show matching, then moderate, filter out, and inquiry help also filter out, no record, right? See, if you remove that, the inquiry is not equal to, right? See, display that all the records where my condition meet. Priority not equal to one means nothing but excluded. Priority one tickets, display the remaining priority, right? And the state not equal to in progress, excluding the in progress records, display the remaining state record. And state A closed, state equal to inquiry help, priority not equal to three moderate. So my condition meet the seven records, those seven records display to the customer. This is third way to apply the filter condition, that is a quick search or filter out. So quick search nothing but a show matching, and filter out nothing but opposite of show matching. Okay, next one is, so what is the purpose of the property? Copy your URL to the clipboard, right? Suppose any customer, they're asking to send this particular record URL, right? So record number 10025, right? So right click on this particular record and copy that URL to the clipboard. So what happened, guys, this is a UI action we can discuss later, what the code is working behind that button, right? Nothing but a link. So what happened, see, now again going to open that notepad, just to have copy that link to my notepad. See that copied clipboard, right? Clipboard nothing but a copy in that particular, like temporary, it can be copy that ID, like a record, right? So if you want to send this record ID directly to the people, so they can paste into here and enter it. Automatically the record can open into that in platform. Clear, guys? Okay, right? Anybody asking that to send that record URL, so you can copy that record URL from clipboard, and then it can be sent to the particular people. And what about copy sys ID? If you create any record in the ServiceNow platform, right? So that was generating automatically, that is called system ID. So that system ID will be have the system ID will have 32 digits of combination of alphabetic and numerics. It is a unique of every record in the instance. So just to you want to know that what is the SSID of the particular record. Suppose I want to know that SSID of record number 24. Let's right click on this one, copy SSID. So this SSID we can use in different places when we working with the coding part. Just I'm going to show how to copy that SSID from that list view. So we can use different places and different purpose. So when we're working practically use that SSID, I will let you know more into that. Okay, so next one is, so what about ascent tag is not required right now. We can discuss later at ascent tag, and archive record also we can discuss later when we're working with plugin concept. And what about assign to me? What about assign to me? So every currently logged in user can be able to ascend the ticket himself. Alright. So when you suppose I can say I have selected record number 05, right? So right click on this one and assign to me. So currently who logged into my system administrator, right? Just click on it, assign to me. Automatically the ticket should be assigned to this current logged in user. Any current logged in user, they want to assign the ticket himself dynamically from that view window list view. So right click on that particular record and assign to me. The record can be assigned to the person dynamically to that user. So what about that follow online feed? Suppose can say example. So this record number 31, which is created by like a VIP customer. This record number, this record is this instant number 31, which was created by VIP customer. So any logged in person, they want to track that. They want to follow the live feed. So when you click on that follow live feed of 31 record, automatically it will be tagging. So follow on live feed of 31. So what has happened, guys? See, so when any customer or delegates and developer, anybody update this particular instant record, then automatically the notification will be sent to the person who already going to follow the record. Right? Why we are going to follow the record? Suppose you can say example. So I'm the business unit owner. So one business customer has created one ticket, instant ticket. He's at my very important customer, VIP customer, right? So when my VIP customer created incident record in incident table, as a business unit head, I need to follow in the live feed. What is the status of that particular record? And so what is the conversation is going to happen between the people like administrator and developer or delegates and customer. So this kind of tracking, if you want to do that in ServiceNow platform, so go together and follow live feed. The particular record is going to be following by the respective current logged in user. Okay. So how can you track it? No need to track it every time, like manually open the ticket. So what happened, guys? When any person updated a ticket in particular, right? So automatically send the notification to me to, so who is that following the particular ticket? That is called follow on live feed, right? Next one is show live feed. What about show live feed, guys? Suppose I can say example, dynamically, if you want to see the, what is that live feed of that record? Record number 26. So right click on this one. Dynamically, it can be open the task. Dynamically, it can be open the details about in same window. So one window open, there is no conversation happened. So I can open that record number 54. Just click on that show live feed. So what is the conversation happened between the people? The person can be able to see that activities. So these all are nothing but activities. So somebody created a ticket. That is what SAP metrics management is slow. There is no outage. So I tell you the same. I cannot log into the application. Need to do some further research. So system administrator is saying that it's totally broke. And so nothing but a something conversation is going to happen between the people. That may be ideal user, administrator, developer, delegates, right? See, in case anybody dynamically they want to see the live status of that particular ticket, dynamically you can be able to click on that show live feed. So display that activities which are which are going to follow the people. So add usual task board to later when we're working on that dashboard. Okay. So this is about so list context menu, guys. Any doubt in that? Guys, any doubts in that? Up to now? Any doubts?
Srinu, Sajay here.
Ajay, please.
Yeah, here you said there is one options we have under in right click, show feed. That is the only the way to check all those conversion, or can we able to say all those details under the incident as well?
So that is under incident. Suppose there is a multiple ways to check that live status of the record. Directly every customer can be able to open the record. There we can be able to see that live status of that. What is the conversation happened between the people, right? There's nothing but activities. Same activities are going to display that window. First way, second way, and sometime automatically you want to get any notification. So what about notification? So we can pass the information automatically through notification. That time we have to implement the notification service platform. So how can you send it? any customer, they update the record, that may be customer or administrator, developer, anybody, automatically send the notification to the people, this time we're going to pass the information, this record was updated by the particular people. That is what RDP. That is automatic
okay.
process, this is a manual process.
Okay, and whom is going that will configure? It gets configured automatically or it will go the
no,
guy
no.
who took it outside?
So when we're working with that incident management lifecycle state model, that time and explore more into that, how they're configured that activity filter format, right?
Okay, yes, okay, got it.
So that is the activity filter format, nothing, but conversation is happening.
Okay, got
that
it.
Good.
These notifications will be getting through mail or will be getting through messages in service now?
So mail only, right, Nazir? So what are the mail it was configured to your Outlook? I suppose I can say when we create any like user record in the service note table, meanwhile we have to configure that email address also. That email address is continuously syncing your Outlook email ID. All right. Okay. So when you set the person of the particular people, then automatically it will be collecting the particular email ID of the user record, then send the notification. So we will discuss later, Nazir. Then we work with the notification concept. That is a very important concept, notifications.
Okay.
That is a chapter number, I think, 23. Currently, we are in only fourth concept. Okay. Don't worry, I will cover everything in the platform. Okay. So do you have any doubts up to now? Up to now, everything is clear, right?
This is Madan.
Madan, please.
ఇది ఫాలో ఆన్ లైఫ్ ఫీడ్ ఉంది కదా వన్స్ అది మనం సెలెక్ట్ చేసిన తర్వాత అది ఆటోమేటిక్ గా అలాగే ఉండిపోద్దా లేకపోతే దాన్ని మళ్ళీ మనం డిసేబుల్ చేయాలా
ఎగ్జాంపుల్ నాట్ మదన్ ఇట్స్ ఏ ఆటోమేటిక్ ప్రాసెస్ వెన్ యూ క్లిక్ ఆన్ దట్ ఫాలో ఆన్ లైఫ్ ఫీడ్ ఇట్స్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఇట్స్ ఏ కైండ్ ఇట్స్ ఏ యూఐ యాక్షన్ సో దట్ ఇస్ వన్ మదన్ రైట్ ఇట్స్ ఏ బటన్ ఆర్ లింక్ రైట్ దట్ ఇస్ యూఐ యాక్షన్ వెన్ యూ క్లిక్ ఆన్ దట్ ఫాలో ఆన్ లైఫ్ ఫీడ్ దెన్ ఆటోమేటిక్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ట్యాగ్డ్ టు దట్ పర్టిక్యులర్ పర్సన్ లుకింగ్ టు లైక్ like looking to like share the information, they want to like get the information from the people, right? So how can you get the life field? And ఏంటంటే దాని మీద మీరు క్లిక్ చేసినప్పుడు ఆ పర్టికులర్ రికార్డ్ లో ఎనీబడి మేక్ సమ్ చేంజెస్ ఇన్ దట్ రికార్డ్ దట్ మే బి లైక్ ఐఎమ్ వర్కింగ్ ఆన్ ద టికెట్ సో ప్లీజ్ కుడ్ యూ ప్రొవైడ్ ద మోర్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆన్ ద టికెట్ సంథింగ్ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు కన్వర్జేషన్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు హ్యాపన్ రైట్ దట్ కన్వర్జేషన్ ఆటోమేటిక్ సెండ్ యాజ్ ఏ నోటిఫికేషన్ త్రూ ఈమెయిల్ సో హూ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు ఫాలో ద లైఫ్ ఫీడ్
సపోజ్ ఆ ఫాలో అవడం ఆగిపోవాలనుకోండి అప్పుడు ఎలాగా
సో యు వాంట్ టు ఫాలో ద లైఫ్ ఫీడ్ రైట్
ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ టు ఫాలో దట్ దెన్
రైట్ సీ రైట్ ది కోడ్ అట్ 0 నెంబర్ 5 అండ్ ఫాలో ఆన్ లైఫ్ ఫీడ్ 005 రైట్ దిస్ వన్
yes
so yes is enabled and again I am going to open at 005 just wait this is all a follow life feed right that is a view incident record we can be open here and subscribe it and it's if you want to make it as a favorite and edit the section so directly go to that all and 005 so again I'm going to so where that follow life feed still click on the follow life feed what is saying that
005.
What is saying that again
already following
so again when I click on that follow on live feed it is saying that already following a live feed right so
yes
I think when you so you are looking to follow live feed I think there is no option to stop it
danlo intaku mundu open cheyinchin danlo leave an chuttu unnattundi
where is it
ok sari live feed open cheyara
wait all I think anybody click on that follow live feed say so once click on that follow live feed maybe until to complete that closer ticket maybe they're going to live feed but not required to like unfollow the live feed of the ticket so when you open this ticket and where is that unfollow you can check it out people okay ne? So my feed company feed group feed record people right and see favorites you can be able to find out here and members and pending members as tag
leave an cheppi undu chusara edhi deniki
leave right see when you call that leave so what is that leave I think I need to check it out mother you can check it out it's a simple so many properties are available okay So specifically, I'm not going to call it. I don't want for the live feed. So maybe we have the option, right? You can check it out. So what about the my feed? It's not required. It's a simple component. So when anybody they want to follow the live feed, we can be able to follow the live feed. If you don't want for the live feed, so in case of so already we discussed, guys. Very important thing. Frequently we need to call, like following the product documentation. All right. So how to unfollow live feed in ServiceNow. Simple. Go to that documentation. Live feed ServiceNow documentation. Follow live feed. Sorry. Live feed documentation. So follow live feed, you can view users who are following that to you, other users who are following, and people that following, who other people are going to following, and who are the followers, and everything you can be able to find out the record. And there, so who is going to follow the records, you can be able to see that. See, to you, the system shows that most recent followers to users you are following. Anybody so who are looking for that, follow the live feed of that, so you can be able to find out the other people in that particular my record, okay? And unfollow that, how can you bookmark feeds and hashtag. So these other details are given in that documentation. In your case, you can follow the documentation, okay? I think it's not required. It's not important in that my platform, okay?
Okay.
I want to explore more into that. Very simple to follow in this other documentation. Very simple.
Okay.
What about the hashtag? And what is this one? And what is that to follow? I think these are follow, I think leave it out, right? Both are there. Okay, so many things are there, and go to here and bookmarks, feeds, and hashtags. See, very simple to follow that live feeds. And last year, just I'm going to explain in that what are the components and properties, features are available in the platform in that list view. Okay, so these are all non mandatory. Frequently, we are going to using that. So copy that, filter out show matching, and these two, and send to me, and remaining follow live feed. Not so many things. Okay, right. Next one is I'm going to working with that list context menu. So this is called list context menu. So we have a two list context menus, right? Now I'm going to work with that list context menu. Every column may be contain list context menu, right? If you want to sort the particular record, so A to Z, yes, display that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1 critical, 2 high, 3 moderate, 4 low, 5 planning. So in case of, if you want to sort in the records, Z to A, nothing but a 6, 5 and something. Clear, guys? So can we be able to write? And next one is group by priority. So what is that group by? See, just click on that, go to configuration, like a list context menu, group by priority. This is a group by priority, right? So we have 31 tickets in critical, 4 in high, nothing but I'm going to categorizing the part each state, each priority. So we have a 31 tickets in a critical, 4 in high, 12 in moderate, 5 in low, 28 in planning. If you want to open that any particular records, click on the priority one, you can be able to open the record. Right? So that is nothing but so how to group by the fields. Every column you can be able to group by it. Right? If you want to group by this field also, group by state, group by category. So when you click on the group by category, so empty records 3, we have a 2 in database. And 10 in hardware category, 48 in inquiry, 6 in network, software 13. Clear, guys? So again, all open all the records in the table, and go to the remaining one. So what about the bar chart and pie chart? Guys, anybody idea about what about bar chart and pie charts? What about the bar chart and pie chart? So some managers, delegate, and other people, they want to look the data in visualization manner. At that time they can be able to upload the data into the bar chart and display the data into bar chart and pie charts. Suppose just to click on that all. So currently we have 82 records in my instant table. So go to the context menu, bar charts. So directly it is going to open the bar chart. So the entire data can be displayed in visualization manner. Why? Because somebody look and feel, that's why they're going to display the data in visualization manner. Only by default, the list view can be supporting bar and pie charts. But if you want to display that number of reporting stage, like number of reporting, there we need to go for reporting application. The different topic, report is a different topic. When we're working with the reports, that time we can explore more into that. Okay, so group by field, suppose state. Now I'm going to group by that field, it's mandatory. Click on that next and save, run it. Simply the entry data is going to be displayed at 13 closed, so 25 new state, in progress 16, and onboard 6, and result 5. Right, guys? So this is nothing but a bar charts. So if you want to open that only all the closed records, when you click on the particular bar, display all the records where the condition meet. Okay. So why we are going to export the data, some customers and end users like delegates, managers, and so many people, anybody they want to look the data, look into the data in visualization manner, they can able to see the data in bar or pie chart. So in case if you want to, suppose I can say an example, go to that all, go to all, right? See all records and same and pie charts, same data. We are going to open in pie chart manner. Okay. So that may be state. Again, I'm going to set the state and next. So save and run it. Very simple. And here, see, we have 30 records in close and result 6 and on hold 6, in progress 16, 25, right? When you click on that any particular box of that pie chart, automatically open the this all records where condition meet, right? So how the data can display that pie and bar charts? Only by list view can be supporting bar and pie chart. We can discuss later about the configuration when we complete it. Before going to complete the session today, I will go to for the configuration. Last topic is that how to configure the list layout, list calculations, list control, right? So these all the things are done by the service administrator. But remaining things, every customer can be able to perform the operation. And what about the import? In case if you want to import any data, if you want to import any bulk data into service node table, so we can be able to import, right? So when we're working with import set concept, I will let you know more into that. And service node platform, right, can be supporting export it. Suppose my incident table, total 82 records. I don't want to export these all 82 records. When we can export the data, I can say example, I'm the manager, right? So I'm the manager of network department. I want to get how many priority one tickets are in network department pool, right? First of all, I need to apply the condition, right? How many priority one tickets? So apply the condition priority, critical one, and that category is network. So I need to get, I'm asking somebody else, right? So I want to get these other records in the report format, right? First of all, we have to apply the condition and where the condition will display all the records. So then go to that my list context menu and export. By default, the ServiceNow platform can be supporting these all files. So if you want to export into Excel, CSV, XML, JSON, PDF, every, right? So based on your current requirement, you can export into a particular file that may be Portrait and Netscape. Then download it. Same kind of activity if you want to perform in any other applications or other platform, we need to write a lot of code. But here, no need to write a single line of code. Very simple to export the data into different files that may be Excel, CSV, and right? So there we can be able to get the data also. Report at least incident list, run date and time. So there were when there are a particular report and run by whom, system administrator, and on which table, incident table, query condition is priority one, and category equal to network. So finally, three records submit my condition, displays the records in the table. There, guys, this is a way how to export the data into different files. So ServiceNow by default can be supporting only these all files, Excel, right? Same data if you want to export into Excel file, same process, right? Your manager asking that only XML format or Excel format, right? See, go to that Excel format. So you can design that Excel sheet, and before going to send it to your manager, we can design that Excel sheet automatically, export in the column values also, right? So here, right, if you want to highlight in that border, yes, this is about Excel sheet. So any manager expecting that particular records in that Excel format, first of all we need to apply the condition from list view, then export it different file formats based on the client requirement, right? So again, click on that all, remove all the condition from the table. Just remember it, no need to write single line of code while exporting the data into any different file formats. So already they are created a different coding, right? Already they are created with my BioTuber system, so you can use it. And next one is export. So what about update selected, guys? What about update selected? Suppose I can say example, I want to update the cell value directly from the list view. Yes, I can be able to update the cell value directly from the list. If you want to update the multiple cell values, go to here, how to update the multiple cell values in multiple records, right? See, critical issue, right? Then click on that here. See, how to update a single record cell value, how to update the multiple record cell value, right? This is a way how to update it. Suppose if you want to update the multiple records, put the cursor here and control and drag the cursor here, right? So this is a way how to update a single cell value and multiple cell value. Okay, every customer can be able to update the single or multiple cell values, right? Next one is, what about update selected? So what about update selected? Suppose if you want to update any particular record in particular cell value, suppose I want to update this 005 record. So from this record, I need to update multiple cell values, right? See, I need to update the multiple cell values in the same record, right? See, I need to update the multiple cell values in a single time without open the record. Priority is a critical and the state is in progress and update selected record, right? And so categories also software and email. So click on that update. So if you want to update the multiple records, multiple cell values in a single record, we can be able to update it. So how to open that updated record? So when you click on that updated record, the latest record will come top always, right? See sorting. So see what happened, guys. So I have updated multiple cell values in single record, right? See high critical, software, email, this one, right? I have updated 7 cell values in a single time. That is the way how to update the selected record in multiple cell values without open the record. So when you click on that, when you select that any particular record, go to here and click on the update set. What happened? Open the empty form. So which one you want to update it, you can update all the values and select it automatically done. So what about the update all, right? Suppose when you click on that update all and click on this one, so total how many records? 82. From that 82 records, if you want to change the start description value, so all 82 records automatically change the start description value, right? First of all, I can apply a condition, just wait, those all records I want to update it. See state, not state. Short description starts with net, right? So these all records I want to update it. How to update these all records? See, go to context menu, update all. So total how many records? 5 records. From these 5 records, I need to update in. So priority high and urgency high priority critical, updating file records to update records and update it. This time we'll do update 4 cell values in file records. One second, guys. I'm getting caught. Sorry guys, I got important call. Okay, fine. So continue the same, right? See, go to that all, display all the records in the table. Then, so go to the context menu. Already we've seen that how to update the record, how to update the multiple records, all right? So same like that, go to that remaining features like import XML. Suppose if you want to import the XML file data, have some records in bulk of records in my Excel file or XML, directly we'll be able to import that into my ServiceNow table. We can see when we're working with import set concept. So that time I can cover all the things in import sets. And next one is the last one in that show XML. So if you want to display the data in XML file dynamically, you can be able to see that. So click on the show XML. The data can be displayed in that XML format. So XML is that universal format. Every person and system also can be able to understand that to converting or integration process we can use it frequently. Right? So this is about context menu, guys. So this is about the context menu. Next one is the list context menu, also there, view, right? In a ServiceNow platform, we have different views. A default view, this is a default view, right? So in that, suppose I can say example, views and mobile. So if you open that mobile view, there we can be able to configure only four columns. In that short, mobile view, suppose any person, they open that instant list view in that mobile, there can be able to see that only four. Why? Because the screen size is very less, right? So based on that, nothing but responsive mode. The ServiceNow platform can be automatically reactive as a responsive mode. And based on that interface and mobile tab and the system, desktop will be automatically display the like portal, right? And the views are like a portal view. There is a different view, service portal view. That is a completely different. In the service portal view, you can be able to see that only these columns. So based on the client requirement, how to configure the views as well. So already, you know, right? Wait. After complete this one, you can be able to understand it. And filters, by default, filters are available. So if you want to create one more filter also, you can be able to add it. I will show you that. So group by, so many fields are available. If you want to group by any particular field, group by, automatic group by the field. Same group of field is available here also. And now we can remove it, all the condition, remove it, right? Next one is a show. How many records you want to display per page? 10 records, 20, 50, 30 something, 50 and 100. And when you make the some changes in at least layout, so if you not reflected directly, so there we can be able to refresh the list. The recent changes will be applied to your list view. Now portal view, right? I can switch it to my default view. The default view can be able to configure these all the columns. Next one is create favorite. This is the very important choice. What about the create favorite? Suppose I can say example, I'm the manager. So I'm the manager of hardware department. So every time when I log into that my platform, always I need to see how many priority one tickets are created related to my hardware department. So I don't want to apply this condition every time. So I can apply the one condition like this and that can be added to as a favorite. How can you apply the filter condition? Already you know, right? See, as a manager, suppose category is hardware and category is manager, hardware category is hardware, and the ticket is priority is critical. Just click on the trial. So it's very difficult to, as a manager, it's very difficult to manager, delegates, any other people. It's very difficult, customer also. So it's very difficult to apply the filter condition every time in my platform. Okay, so I can apply this filter condition once, and I need to get it every time when you log into the platform. So create the here filter condition and go to my list condition menu, create as a favorite. So while creating that any favorite, if you want to add that any particular, see, if you want to change that name also, what is that name? So priority hardware. right? If you want to add any particular icon, yes, you can be able to add the particular icon. Click on the done. Automatically, the condition will be added to your favorite, right? See priority one hardware. So when you click on this one, automatically display those all tickets. No need to apply the condition every time when you want to get particular records from the table. So we can apply the condition, we can be able to access the every time. This is about last one option, is that favorite. So any doubt in that, guys, up to now? So these all the operations are performed by the ServiceNow customers and developers, other people, everybody. So there is a multiple ways to apply the filter condition. Everybody frequently they're going to apply the filter condition. These are all the ways. And so mainly purpose of that, sort the record, search the record, apply the different conditions to get the records from the table. Okay, right? Next one. So basically, what is my activity, guys? So up to now, just I have explained what is the list view, nothing but a collection of record. So in that list of the records, what we can do, apply the condition, and through condition builder or multiple ways, sort the records, search the records, different so many ways. Update the single cell value, update the multiple cell values. So many things we have done, right? Now, what is our ServiceNow administrator activity? So only we have limited activities in that. So in my incident list view, first of all, go to that home and navigate into incident. Just click on it, all module. So guys, applications and modules, when we're working with implementation concept, the time we can, I can show you that practically how to create that application module. So what happened here, see, this is my list view. So in my incident list view, how many columns we are going to display right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So by default, they're configured and going to display 11 columns. As per my client requirement, we need to display only 6 columns. So how can you remove those all the columns from that list view? So only ServiceNow administrator can be able to configure it. Who can change the list layout? So in that my list layout, we have 11 columns. Based on the client requirement, I need to configure only 6 columns. Go to the configuration. This configuration button should be visible to only ServiceNow administrator and developer. And click on that list layout. Click on the list layout. See, these all the columns already displaying in my list view. So as per the client requirement, I'm going to remove these all the fields, right? Columns, and save it. Now, every customer can be able to see only 6 columns. Only ServiceNow developer or administrator can change the list layout. Okay, that is our main activity in list view. So nothing apart from that, guys. Only these two activities. And next one is list calculations. Suppose we have a priority and category, right? We have two columns. So in priority column, I need to apply the list calculation. So what about list calculation? So if you want to calculate that minimum, maximum, average, and other values, some of the values, right? See, how can you calculating without coding? Context menu, configure, and list calculations. So which value you want to get it? Only minimum, enable the checkbox minimum. Only maximum, enable the checkbox maximum. Get all the values, enable all the checkboxes. Just click on that, okay. And scroll down under the same column, scroll down under the same column. So when you apply that any list calculation, automatically the calculation will be applied to under that column of the values, columns, right? See. So average 2.79, minimum is a critical, nothing but a critical is a one, right? Two, high, three, moderate, four, low, five, planning, six, very critical. So minimum is a one, critical, maximum is a six, very critical. And some of we have created, so we have 229 records, and in that I have average of that each priority, we have 2.9. Automatically calculating nothing but aggregation of the records, aggregation. Okay, so next one.
Sir, what is that average?
So is that average? Nothing but so total how many records are average of the each priority? Here minimum is the critical, nothing but a minimum priority is the critical, maximum priority is that six. Actually it's not a six, I have created it recently. All right, so average nothing but a total how many tickets, 82 tickets in my list, instant list view. So what is that average of that each priority? 2.79. it is equal to calculate automatically, right?
No, no, there are total 82 records, right? Then what is 229?
No, I have deleted so many records.
Okay,
it's applying that all the records. Basically I deleted the records also here. I'm going to use the instance right long back.
Okay, then why it is still 229 if you deleted?
Delete means nothing but explain continuously working on the different topic, right? That time I can so when we work in the table concept, I can delete the so many records. So how to delete the records? In case if you delete the records, unfortunately, how can you recover that? Okay. So in that I will show you that. So don't worry about this one, guys. It's a very simple topic. It's a property. How to calculate the list configurations? Sorry, list calculations. No need to apply the no need to write a single line of code. Directly, if you apply the list calculations, it will be applied to your particular column.
Srinivas, may I know where do we use this concept?
Nothing but it's a kind of aggregation, Jeff. So I can say an example. If you want to suppose total have 500 tickets. So what is the average of that all the priority tickets? That may be 10.2, something, right? So how can you calculate? Suppose if you have 100 tickets, you can be able to calculate it manually. But if you have lack of records, it's very difficult to calculate the aggregation, right? Aggregation nothing but some minimum, maximum, average, right? This kind of calculations, it's not possible to do that manually. So that's why they're given that list calculations, right? So which column you want to apply the list calculations? Select the column and list calculations, automatically apply it. Okay, and again go to, if you want to remove it, how can you remove it? How can you remove it? So if you don't want to apply any columns, so click on this one here. Okay.
Can you give any scenario where we can use, if some requester asks for where we can use this concept?
So just wait. So when we're working with Glade aggregation is the one API is there in scripting part. That time I can show you that. So nothing but average, okay, of the record, minimum of the record. What is the minimum? What is the maximum? Suppose 1 to 100. What is the minimum value? 1, right? What is the maximum value? 100.
Right.
Same like that. Here we are going to calculate. One is that somebody can please you can mute Vijay and Ajay. Right? See, somebody they want to calculate the mean value, average, sum, maximum, minimum. These are all the things you can be able to calculate it through automatically, without writing any single line of code, right? That is the list calculations. Okay, so if you remove, right, not going to display that any particular under the column. So if you want to apply the multiple columns also, every column you can go that and configure it list calculations. Every column separately, if you want to calculate list calculations, you can be able to calculate, but not going to use it frequently, but just a feature is there, just I'm going to explain. Okay, just a second, guys. So this is about list calculations, guys. Tomorrow we can continue the same. First of 5 minutes, I will this is nothing but a configuration. Only ServiceNow developer or administrator can be able to configure or change the list layout and apply the list calculations. And so one more last concept in the list layout, that is called configure and control. And so tomorrow we can discuss about the list controls and what is the difference between customization and personalization. So these are all the things we can discuss tomorrow, guys. Clear? Okay. Abhishek, Afreen, Ajay, Madan, Nazir, Pavan, Vijay. So any doubt up to now? All right.
No, sir. Can you please share the recording as well, if possible?
Who is that? Ajay. Okay.
So, yes.
So everybody completed, contact to admin team. I will share the videos. Okay.
Yeah, I already contacted to Anu, sir. She said she will be he will be sharing the video.
Different. Okay, I will share that video, but I need to get the confirmation from that management. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Tomorrow, end of the day tomorrow, I can complete it. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, guys. Thanks for your time. Have a nice day. Bye bye.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Bye, everyone.